I'm very delighted to join this session. So as Prashant has introduced, I'm basically a veterinarian and nowadays contributing towards different field, not only the veterinary side, but also the economic side, how we can improve the livelihood of the smallholders, especially in developing countries. So I would like to moderate the session today. Before introducing our eminent speakers, I would like to give an overview of the production systems, what we are talking today, because the participants are from global. So we would like to see the different system in developing and developed state countries. So developed countries, the dairy production system has changed to the industrial production system or large farms, which is depending on the demand and price driven approach. But on the other hand, in the developing countries, our system is still in the resource driven. In the developing countries, there are two systems we have. One is the crop livestock systems that is prominent in Asian region, including India, Nepal, Bangladesh and all. But in the other hand, the other sector, like in African region, most of the system is pastoral system. Both these systems are resource-driven system. Especially if you take the pastoral systems, they don't change much with the price fluctuations in the dairy products and all. But if you take in the industrial system, the system changes very heavily with the price fluctuations. That's the main difference we have. We have some advantage with the production system in developing countries because for example, if you take dairy production system is a crop livestock system. So it is a highly integrated system with the crop production. So the people who own dairy animals, not only for the milk production, but there is a multiple use for the dairy, keeping the dairy animals. That's like household milk consumption and also manure and a drought power for their land also. So we have to see the dairy production in the long run along with the production system they are placed. That's also important thing to talk on today. I will also agree with Tanvir. India is number one in production because it's the grace of the farmers, which I will say. I'm also from the farming families. My mother was with the 6 buffaloes with that we studied and all. In India, dairy production is being not considered as a commercial activity. That's why I said in my introduction session that India dairy sector is the integrated part of the crop livestock sector. So many, like 70% to 80% of the producers, they do not consider dairy as a commercial activity. Earlier, India dairy production was more subsistence farming. Now it has been turned to the livelihood aspect due to the operation flood and all. Now, because and the other factor is that much climate change and all made the agriculture sector a little bit erratic and the price fluctuation. There is lot of loss to the farmers in the agricultural sector. That time they have concentrated much into the dairy sector because small and marginal farmers, because dairy animals are owned by more than 80% of the animals are owned by the marginal and small farmers. How the changes, what's the expectation in the future? If you see that we are producing number one animal milk production, not because of the productivity, it is because of the number of animals. It's growing. That's the reason we are number one. How we can see in the future, we have to reduce, because land is a constraint. Marginal and small will become marginal after 10 to 20 years. So how we are going to cope up with the dairy production? Land is a constraint, how we will increase the production, because the population is higher. To meet the demand, what's the way forward? We have to increase the productivity, but there is very less concentration on the productivity gap in India. I think Tanvir also will agree me because he's an animal nutritionist also. The productivity gap in India is very high. It's more than 50%. The potential production is not being reached. Either it is our own breed or the crossbreed also, we have not reached to the We are following the system of low input and low output system because the farmers are living within the agri production system. How we have to transform this to through the technologies and through the better evidence-based extension system will be the future in India. It's little bit going towards that. As Anup said, that many entrepreneurs are emerging, and the IT sector guys and some graduate guys are coming. Youth are coming inside the dairy sector, trying to introduce the technologies and the breed improvement and the feed improvement. These are the main factors which can drive the dairy sector in future to meet our own demand. Otherwise, as Steve said, we can become an importer of milk in future. That's my opinion. One part in the price fluctuation in India, India price is being set with the base price is cooperative price, which is being done by the cooperatives. Now India is transforming towards the FPOs, like farmer producer organizations, which will have better bargaining power to negotiate the price. That will be the future for the price. And the price in one thing is that production factor. Production cost is getting very higher in India because of the concentrate price. The compound feed which we are getting, it is having the competing with the poultry sector. The price for the concentrate is growing very high and high, but the price of the milk is not increasing to that. How we can increase the bargaining power of the farmers, it is in the future question. That is being transforming, the institutional things are being transformed.